All right, and the final one, the deepest, the most recognized songish, that beat, the way it just fades in and out with what the subject matter, what he's doing with it, is just like, and because, and you know why? It's because it's produced by Seven. Like, this is just masterful beat work between an artist and a producer, the way they manage in and out of the bridge and the hook and the verses flawlessly.
See, this was one of the notes that I put down for what I knew we were going to do this video, is the fact that Seven produces beat. So this shows that Seven has still got it. But it, like, I cannot speak enough on how Tech has got him producing these just formulaic fucking trash ass beats. Like, his beats have been weak on his Tech stuff, and I feel like Tech isn't doing him justice, because this dude still got it. This beat is a masterpiece when put into this song. Like, the way they collab on this one, it is truly, like, the essence of, like, someone's, like, craft and artwork. Like, this is a 12 out of 10 from start to finish. The way they play with the beat, with what he's doing with his lyrics, it is truly a masterpiece.
Yeah, so this was my favorite song on the whole EP, and for reasons like Aaron said, it's the deepest one, like it's the one that resonates most with me. And Aaron, it's funny that like we're doing this now, and me and you just got done talking about how people just hate homeless and like people who are beneath them because like that whole shit you said about how like, they see themselves failing and they hate it, but they should see that this. Instead of seeing themselves, they should see this could be anyone that just had like the worst lot in life. And instead of looking down, we got help raising them up.
Well, you sound like Jesus.
Well, even to the point to like, this goes back to like, there's a lot of economic ladder to this song. So like, people see poor and assume they're not trying, assume they don't care. He brings up in one part of his verse, and you know, it fades out, and the guy starts talking. And
he goes into like, I try and get a job. I go in with the application, and be like, all right, we'll call you. And he's like, well, I don't have a phone.
I don't have a phone. So yeah, how so you,
like, a chance.
You can't get ahead from being behind.
Yeah, and that's capitalism at its finest, by the way.
But
that's what that whole thing is about.
It speaks a lot to what people take for granted, because the guy talks about, you know, he's never felt freer.
Whoa,
and it's a good. It's a good point, because, I mean, even what Rex says in the song is, you know, these things that we own end up owning us, especially if something happens and we're not financially stable anymore. All the shit that we thought we owned has our lives, you know, bottlenecked.
Student loan.
So are you really free when you own all this? When you have more wealth, are you really freer than if you had none?
All right, so that was something I want to talk about. So the bar is, the dude's saying to Rex, I ain't got nothing but the clothes on my back. And he's like, but he feels more free. Wait, actually, let me look up. Actually, I can look up the notes on Genius.
And I had a point I wanted to say about the second half as well. When he talks about giving the guy money.
Oh, yeah. He's talking about, like, are you going to say this to turn around, make the world a better place? Or are you just going to, like, spend it on some booze money or whatever?
Yeah, that's a good point. People don't donate.
But then he takes the sting out of it, though, with the next bar.
Yeah, people are afraid to give money because it's, you know, what would they do with it?
Well, and here's the thing, you know, I get that, but coming from, like, I just want to drink or, like, spend it on, like, the plant or heroin, meth, or whatever. It just like Aaron said, it takes a sting out of it. Hell, people who got money still drink. It's like, yeah,
that's the point I was going to bring up. How many people, you know, live paycheck to paycheck and don't need to spend the money on it, but still do?
Yeah, and like they still drink. Like, dude, and like, that's just the way it be. It's like life is hard sometimes. And sometimes
people have their scapegoats. And yeah, just because you give someone money, it's no longer yours anymore. What does it matter what that person does with their finances, right? Like, sure. How many people, instead of putting gas in their car or buying some food or simply putting the money in savings, will go buy a $20 bottle of booze or, you know, go buy a 12-pack of beer or something like that? It's like, you didn't need to spend the money, but you did. You're living paycheck to paycheck. You could easily save that money, but you didn't. You still bought it. So why are you hating on someone who doesn't, you know, have the house or the car or the phone, who still decides to go to his scapegoat to do that?
Well, it's because it's like that shit I said at the beginning of this of us talking about the song. People see themselves in that. It's like, man, they don't want to make that decision of like, or they want to look introvertly and look at it as like, damn, I spend my last dollar on booze every now and then, but you know, I have a way to deal with it. So they don't want to look at themselves and critique themselves like that.
Yeah. And it's also like a never putting your foot in someone else's shoes. If you're in that situation, you can't tell me you wouldn't. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you sleeping in boxes and shit. You know, you
If you
can't
had the
tell me.
chance to go get some booze, you would do it.
Oh yeah. Well, I take any chance to go get booze now.
Like it's human nature, and this divide that we have amongst like people who are not that far off your economic ladder is it's really heartbreaking.
For
'Cause
some reason, people hate other poor people.
like that's what I never understand. You have more in common with that dude who doesn't have any money and no house than you ever will
And Jeff Bezos.
with
That
people
Neo lyric.
who control your life, right? So it really is disheartening, and people have this mindset, and the song really sheds a light on the way people think, and the way he goes about it in this song is really nice, because it's not, it's there. Everyone thinks this way. Everyone knows it, but the way he does it is not preachy. It's more conversation-esque than Hobson. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, it's more, I'm having a conversation with this guy, and here's
Well, he
how
literally
people think
does.
compared to like,
There's that part in the song where he's literally like, he's talking to like his dad or some shit,
shout out.
and he's like, I feel bad about like the kid that's with him. Like they don't know what's wrong, but like they're paying for it either way, and people still hate on them. Like, oh, you're poor with a kid. How dare you be poor with a kid? Like they chose that life.
Yeah. And like I said, he goes about it in more of a conversation-esque way, which really takes away the, you can have a song like this and it not be so preachy to where it turns people off. That's
It's because it.
one of the things that's very, very well done in this song, 'cause that can be so easily undermined. It's really, really well done. 'Cause that's a lot of things, that's a lot of beef that people have with Hobson. And he'll talk about issues like this, but it comes off as very, very, very preachy. And it's just his opinion.
I think it's because his like aggression levels, like his delivery, but it's that, you know, I'm talking to you, not talking down to you.
And as to where
You
this
know.
is, you're merely a third party listening in on this
Yeah.
conversation, right? And it's
Yeah,
still very witty, it's still very deep, and it's still a deep topic.
I think the best part about it is like I feel like we've all had those like these thoughts whenever like we see a guy that's homeless. Like we're just like, yeah, you know, I want to do more. I want to do more for him.
Exactly. That's what I was alluding to. Is like this is something that everyone has thought. You know what I mean? This is a thought process that has gone through everyone's mind when they've seen someone talk about homeless people, or have seen homeless people, or the way the news displays homeless people. Like this is a thought process and a conversation that, you know, a lot of people could have very well had.
Shit, you want to talk about how the news views homeless people? Like, if you don't think like the way we handle like the homeless situation in America is fucked up, cities literally pay money to try and get rid of homeless people. Like they build cities in a way that it makes it harder for homeless people to live there. Like they slant, you know, the things underneath the bridges, and like they put like concrete kind of spikes so they can't sleep on it.
And I would like to point out this is why good hip hop means so much, 'cause like just this song alone, guys talking about homeless people and how they're treated like shit sometimes. And like, you know, this is why good hip hop means something to people, and this is why artists like this need to be better displayed, 'cause you have songs like this that can really get you thinking about something that matters. Or you can have, you know, name your dude Future 2 Chainz. You can
Yeah,
have
how many
these
chains?
whack cats who are
I was
only
trying
talking
to
about how much better his life is than yours.
I'm trying to think of like a popular line that don't make no damn sense, but I can't think of one.
What
By
is
one of them.
your what's your take, Aaron?
So that lyric was, "I ain't got nothing but the clothes that's on my back," he said. "I feel more free than I ever have. I'm freer than that car you drive or what you pay in tax." And then Rick comes back, "I guess I said, damn, I often think too true. I don't know. I don't trust some of these lyrics translations. It says, I often think too truly I'm the man. I really like that part.
That whole shit about, like, your possessions will come on you, like that.
Yeah, you guys nailed that. That's some of the most
truthful shit ever. It's just, like, it's literally, like, if you, like, let's say you come down rough on life, but you got all this shit, like, your car ain't paid off, like, you still got a mortgage. I don't want one. But you essentially stop working for yourself to improve your lot in life, and you're literally only working to uphold your luxuries, like your status. And it's not fulfilling. And if anything in life, like you want to do shit that fulfills you. Now you want to work so you can live, not live so you can work.
And then both verses end with that four-bar scheme where he says, but if I give you this money, would you aim for something big? And he goes on there. Both of them. I like when artists do that. I like how, like, on, what was it, the first song or the second song, one of them, they're the Sycophants and then Sycophants. Like, I like when they double up. Wreck did that.
That was Low Water.
On Low Water. And Wreck did that on that one, was it Modern Man? On that album.
He did it on Into the Further on the song. He did it on Into the Further. What song was that? Basically Numb. He did it on Basically Numb. That was a good song.
And then I got this song is Smooth and Deep. And also, if you want to... And then Horseshoe Gang has a song called Homeless. And it has a video. And it's basically the other side of this whole recognized song where it's from the being homeless perspective. So when I hear this song, I think of that song type of thing.
So are we doing the... The category?
I mean, it's too short. Don't matter. I mean, they're all great. There's not like so they're say, bad.
We're just going to classify all of them as great and classify two of them as deep.
I mean, but real I deep. Banged all three except for Anyway. Like, I don't have a problem playing Man on the Bridge. That shit, that seven beat's real nice. Like, I'd put that in that banger category or Depends at worst. If we're going back to the ISO one. I mean, that Anyway beat banged too. Like, you can bang all of these.
Yeah, all
the top two are like slumpers.
So Bruce's favorite is Man Under the Bridge, obviously. Least favorite is The Fallen.
Yes, yes.
Which yeah, I don't agree with at all.
You can feel free to not disagree, but I feel
like Aaron's is favorite is The Fallen, and least favorite is Anyway.
Yep.
My least favorite out of these is Anyway, obviously. It's a really good song, but it's not near the caliber as Low Water or Man Under the Bridge.
He likes making breakup songs.
My favorite is damn near a tie.
What is it?
It's a photo finish.
But just with how smooth the beat is and how he plays with it in his flow, I gotta say The Fallen is my favorite, and Low Water is a very close second. I really thought, when I first listened to this stuff, I really thought Low Water was my favorite.
Whoa.
Just because that beat is nasty. And how he goes hard, but he's going hard talking about what he's talking about. I was like, okay, Low Water, like, how you gonna top this on this album? On this EP? And then Fallen has grown on me since I started listening to it, because it's so smooth. The way he plays with it is nice.
How smooth is it? If you have to describe the smoothness.
It's smooth. It's real smooth.
Sounds like
there's just something about that song. It's so captivating when you really listen to it. It's like, it doesn't speak to you when he goes, get up with the falling. The falling. It's one of those that really like makes you like, I don't know, you get into that song.
Hey man, The Fallen know how to make music.
Yeah, I mean, The Fallen.
Double tanks.
Fallen's good. A close second is Low Water, as far as my favorite ones.
I think Low Water is more bangable, but I think Man Under the Bridge is better.
I think Low Water is more bangable. I think Man Under the Bridge is a better song.
Yeah. So yeah, my order would just be.
I think the best song on the album is Man Under the Bridge.
I don't know. It's close. I still think
Fallen. For sure. I would say Man Under the Bridge 1, Low Water 2, The Fallen 3, Anyway 4. Would be my official list. My favorite one to like just listen to is The Fallen.
That's overall.
Maybe I gotta go through and listen to The Fallen a couple more times.
Put that one in the whip.
I listened to this whole thing in the whip, man.
You gotta get your
And
speakers
then
checked. They might not be
I
on.
sat then I sat down and listened to it.
So, overall on the album, dynamic beats, deep subject matter, and maybe it's just our thirst, but it's a lot of Sonny Winter vibes just because of how crazy different the beats are compared to the other projects he's done, and the subject matter is nowhere near what you would have expected going into just any normal project.
Yeah,
Nice.
definitely a Sonny Winter vibe. And Rec,
Yeah.
if you happen to watch this doc, we need a Sonny Winter 3, please. I'm begging you for a Sonny Winter 3. I look forward to your upcoming projects because you set the bar high for yourself these past couple years, and you continue to drop dope shit.
By the way, one thing I forgot to mention was something that I covered extensively in the ISO vid was how the songs like kind of mesh together like a story. I think it's super fitting that Man of the Bridge comes after Anyway. Anyway
Yeah.
is all about greed and people taking more, and then Man of the Bridge is about a dude who has nothing and you want to give.
Well, I mean, you could also look at it as you started out near low water because you're the fallen. Because you've said fuck it anyways, and then you end up being the man under the bridge. Or it's Rex's journey where he's walking past the low water, he's seeing the fallen because he likes them. You know, why is he walking this path? Because it's the anyway, and then he runs across a man on the bridge while he's walking on. Like, if you look at the album cover type of thing, like, you know, who
Yeah.
knew?
Sure. It's a
So,
good
yeah, you're
point.
right, though. There's, I mean, that's, you know, Rex a master artist, though. I mean, you'd hope he wouldn't have just picked four random songs.
I was gonna point out that's what sets an artist like when they put out something and it's cohesive, because that was one of the one things I always loved and why that album I still listen to, Congratulations by Mac Lethal, that album was a statement. You know what I mean? Like that album was a theme from song to song. They flowed so natural together on topic matter that it was just like an experience to listen to. And that's what's great about EPs and albums that he's put out and other artists for that matter.
Whoa.
Like it's really an experience. You're not just having to suffer through certain songs like the Jail album. You're just along for the ride.
Shameless plug.
And every song just links together so nice that you're along for the ride.
They got on Discogs, they got the style, and it says conscious. All right, well, that's the recognized one. That's that one.
That's it.
That's
That's it.
it.
Yeah, I'll tell you what we need to talk about.
Keeps f***ing telling me you're broadcasting. It's getting annoying.
Good. You need to know that I'm broadcasting.
Build another.